Welcome back, guys, to another video. Now, before we get started, definitely check out the Discord server. We just hit 10,000 members, so definitely check it out. And also, it's completely free, and there's also a Webull sign-up link. Sign up for Webull, make a brokerage account, deposit $100, and get 2 free stocks. It's literally free money. So let's talk about Workhorse and what is going on here. So for a very long time, I have always been pretty bullish on Workhorse because, in my opinion, they have little to no competition, especially here in the US. Now, I get it, you know, they make these van trucks that are fully electric and they're part of the logistics service. They might have some competition here and there, but let's be honest here. If you type in the last mile logistics EV truck, Workhorse is usually the first one that pops up. I get it, Rivian's doing it, but they don't even have a factory up yet. And you got other companies doing it, but they're just startups. So Workhorse is doing a phenomenal job. So before we dive in any deeper, let's talk about what their company is and why their stock literally jumped over 6 to 7% this morning, August 31st, pre-market. What in the world is going on? So they pretty much make these last mile logistics trucks. So you know how like Nikola Motors, Hyliion, and Tesla are making these really nice electric or hydrogen semi trucks? Yeah, that's pretty cool and all, but keep in mind that that's only one part of a logistics page. Now, there's a lot of things part of logistics. You know, you got the cargo ships, the planes, and then you got to load them up in semi trucks. The semi trucks will be docked into these giant trucking facilities in your local cities. And then those packages will be unloaded from the trucks to these smaller vans right here. You see the 650 and the C1000. The 650 could most likely be a mail truck, and the C1000 is obviously a very big package truck. And then these smaller trucks would drive to your local neighborhoods, and these will be like the trucks that actually drop things off to your front door. Like, you probably have seen multiple times that those FedEx and UPS trucks, they are not giant semi trucks. Like, I don't even think those trucks even fit in a small neighborhood. So they gotta use these smaller vehicles. It's much easier. Each vehicle is assigned a specific couple of neighborhoods, and they deliver the goods, and then they go back to the facility. You get the idea. That's how it usually goes. And logistics is becoming bigger and bigger. Keep in mind that FedEx, UPS, DHL are recording record amount of sales because of e-commerce. More people are shopping online than ever before, which makes those guys having a lot of business. In return, with everyone changing to electric, they're gonna have to order a large bulk of electric vans, and guess where they're gonna order it from? Workhorse, most likely. Because why? They already have a factory. They're already cranking out vehicles. Keep in mind, on Twitter, they have a vehicle of them literally cranking out a car. And the CEO even said like they want to increase production from 300 to 400 vehicles per year. So they literally are producing vehicles. This is not a concept. It's not like, oh, they don't have a factory. They have a factory. And on top of that, ARK Invest actually bought a lot of shares of Workhorse and is part of her ETF. It's actually insane. When Cathie Wood buys something, you guys should probably check it out as well. So what's going on here? So Workhorse stock jumps after a huge agreement with Hitachi. So this is a pretty big deal, especially how Workhorse stock has been very low key recently. In fact, this whole week has been just dipping and dipping and dipping. And then finally this morning, news of them working with Hitachi finally came out and the stock absolutely jumped in. Now, if you do some technical analysis, you probably have seen something very crazy. Every time when Workhorse hits about $17 to $18, it generally speaking drops all the way down to the lows of $15 to $16. And when it hits $15 to $16 for quite some time, eventually it goes up for a big news. It goes down, it goes up, it goes down, and now it's going back up again. I mean, this is what Workhorse is doing. Like, honestly though, if you guys want to run the wheel, like selling cash secure puts and cover calls on Workhorse, it's probably a pretty good stock to do it because it doesn't really like to go up that much and doesn't like to go down that much. And history pretty much gives you a good idea. Every time a Workhorse stays in a single spot for too long, it usually jumps on initial hype of some news. It drops, it jumps, it drops. Very similar to like this week. You know, it jumped, it dropped to like $16, and now it jumped again because of news about Hitachi. So what is this really insane news about Hitachi, and why should we even care? So pretty much under these agreements, Hitachi America and also other Hitachi Group companies will be getting Workhorse a very good assessment on the manufacturing, the supply chain, and also et cetera, and operational things. Now, this may seem kind of silly, but keep in mind that a big company like Workhorse, you must keep track of your expenses, what your supply chains are giving out, and if you screw up, there's going to be giant delays in your vans, which of course makes the guys who order the trucks extremely mad, because if I'm ordering a truck and you say it's going to be in my front door in 1 month and it's taking like 3 months, I'm going to be pretty upset. So they hired Hitachi to provide a very good outlook and just see where the supply chains are. Keep in mind that they know production is the hardest part for any electric car company. And keep in mind that if you can master the art of the factory for EVs, you could definitely make a lot of money and be first class. Now, another big thing is it will help Workhorse increase production requirements and also financing for other individuals. This is going to be pretty big as well. Especially if you check this out, it will be trying to develop a national dealer network and help Workhorse be like helping them with finance for the dealers and the consumers. This is very big, especially how you have rumors like the U.S. Postal Service going to reward somebody $6.3 billion for a new mail truck, and the truck must be built in the USA. Huh, I wonder who they're going to pick. Most likely going to be Workhorse. Because why? First of all, they're fully electric. I highly doubt the U.S. Postal Service will be ordering another set of gasoline trucks, which are very short-lived. Electric trucks are low maintenance, and on top of that, wait for it, very, very low amount of monies to run. Second, Workhorse is made in America. They have a factory here. It's not like they have a factory overseas. It's just not like they're like an overseas company. They're in America. It's made in America, and these are pretty good. I feel like Workhorse probably knows that they might be getting a huge order pretty soon because Cathy Wood and ARK Invest, they do their research. They bought into Workhorse even though it's already surged up to $15 to $16. But because I feel like people know the market cap for Workhorse of only $1.72 billion is super small, and just simply if they do get the U.S. Postal Service reward, it's $6.3 billion. Workhorse stock will absolutely explode up. And when one giant company orders from Workhorse, guess what? Everyone else orders it from Workhorse. Because if they are not expecting some sort of a major order in the future, they would not be partnering up with Hitachi on this. Because this is a strategic agreement. And right now they're developing like a dealer network and they want to help people with financing. This is insane because when you got big customers, big and small, that are ordering your vehicles, you need to help them with financing options. And this is where Hitachi comes in. So this is pretty big news and a lot of people are slowly getting hyped up because Workhorse, unlike other major EV companies out there and startups, Workhorse actually has their own factory. This is a really big deal. The reason why, if you check out the one-year chart, they haven't actually dropped all the way down like most SPACs and most EV companies is because they have a factory. When you have a factory, you drop and you stabilize. Very similar to NIO and very similar to Diamond Peak Holdings, which is Lordstown Motors. So should you guys buy Workhorse? I really do feel like it. I mean, if Cathy Wood and ARK Invest bought like a lot of shares, it's honestly a very good company. I have been really bullish on Workhorse for a very long time because they have very little amounts of competition. The last mile logistics van is very important in any logistics service. Keep in mind, e-commerce is becoming bigger and bigger than ever before. DHL, FedEx, UPS, US Postal Service, and also other smaller logistics companies around the whole entire country, even around the globe, they need these vans. It's not like we could survive on gasoline for a very long time. Like, I'm pretty sure they have to change their whole fleet in the next few years. And especially how Workhorse is pretty much one of the best options out there. It's US certified for safety. They have a factory. They have two different vans. One's a smaller vehicle, which there looks like a mail truck. And the other is like a bigger vehicle where it can actually store more items. You can clearly see they have two different models on top of that. They even have a drone delivering system that they're researching. So things are looking pretty good for Workhorse. And they're absolutely serious about the logistics services. That's about it. Thanks for watching and comment below.